A new Ipsos poll done exclusively for Global News shows the Liberals have expanded their lead. The Ipsos poll shows if an election were held today, the Liberals would receive 35% of the decided popular vote, up 2% from last month. The Conservatives, led by Erin O'Toole, stand at 28%, down 2%. The NDP are at 16%, the Green Party at 10%, and the Bloc Québécois at 7%. The only poll that counts, of course, is on Election Day, but the upheaval of the pandemic does not appear to have hurt the Liberals politically. And the challenge for the Conservative leader is finding a way to gain traction. Our chief political correspondent, David Akin, is looking at this. David, the challenge for O'Toole is not just to win over voters, but also, it seems, some skeptical Conservative MPs.
Yeah, you know, Don, in fact, there are a lot of Conservative MPs who are deeply unhappy and frustrated with O'Toole's leadership. None, mind you, would come on TV to voice their concerns. But I have talked to about a dozen MPs today and over the weekend, and it is a significant group, mostly from Western Canada and from rural Canada. O'Toole's first misstep, they tell me, was the decision to boot Social Conservative Ontario MP Derek Sloan out of caucus. It was done wrong and done for the wrong reasons. And that came as O'Toole was doing what's been described to me as a pivot from the persona he took on to win the leadership race.
It's time for a true blue conservative who can win the next election,
to what he's perceived to be now, a red Tory from Eastern Canada. In a Conservative circles, Donna, calling someone a red Tory, well, that can be fighting words. Now, these MPs now worry O'Toole's red Tory tendencies will result in a climate change policy that puts a price on carbon. In other words, a carbon tax. And that's a mainstream idea among all other parties, but that is anathema to most Conservatives. Finally, many in his caucus are upset at the removal of Pierre Poilievre as finance critic. Poilievre is very popular within his party. And O'Toole's decision to make Poilievre the jobs critic, well, that is seen largely as a demotion of a potential leadership rival.
David, what then could be the path forward for the Tories and for O'Toole himself? How do they fix this?
Well, the party's convention next week is going to be a crucial benchmark. And Sloan and many social conservatives will be out to sandbag O'Toole, and he has to make sure that he prevents that from happening. Now, O'Toole also, his supporters say, is a much more confident leader than his predecessor, Andrew Scheer, and he has to show it. Now, O'Toole must also convince Western and rural MPs and party members that he can deliver votes in Eastern and urban Canada, and he has to do that without alienating that Western and rural base. It's a tall order, but O'Toole must address this frustration in his own ranks before he can address the concerns of the Canadians he'll need to win over to win an election. Donna?
David Akin in Ottawa, thanks.